In the studio we have Sara Chandler.
Buongiorno Tony, buongiorno
Buongiorno Sara.
Eleonora.
Ciao.
Sara is taking me on this journey along the Italian language. And this morning, Sara, we're going to talk about vocabulary. I want to improve my vocabulary.
And more than vocabulary, Tony, we're going to do sounds, which is always the biggest problem for English-speaking people. You know what? Like, we were talking before about spellings. In Italian, spelling is so easy.
Spelling?
We don't have problems in spelling. Don't we, Leonora?
It's pretty easy.
Yeah, you just pronounce it as you write it, so not a problem.
Yeah, that's
Okay.
true, but there are other problems that's associated with the Italian language.
Yeah.
Anyway, we won't get into all
No.
that. So, what we're going to do is improve my vocabulary. That means increase the number of words that I know. And we're then going to talk about the sounds of those words.
Exactly.
I vocali.
Le vocali.
The vowels.
The vowels, sì. Conosci le vocali,
well,
Tony?
I do. In English we would say A, E, I, O, U. In Italian,
sì.
It's A.
A.
E.
Sì.
I. O. I don't know the U.
Ooh.
Ooh.
But you know what the difference is? That the Italian vowels always stay the same. While English vowels, they change.
What do you mean?
Like E, for example. Sometimes it's E, like get.
Oh, okay.
Sometimes it's E. But yes. Italian ones, you can always trust them.
But we don't even think about it. It just comes out naturally.
I know, but for us it's difficult when we want to learn English. So Italian is just easier.
Yeah.
I have students every day telling me how difficult Italian is, but it's not true. So
okay.
A, E, I, O, U. That's it.
A, E, I, O, U.
So plane is a good word to learn them.
Aereo.
Aereo. Bravo.
Aereo.
Or also the country that we are in now.
Australia.
Australia.
Oh.
A U.
You have to pronounce them all, don't you?
Sì.
How do you say it, Eleanor?
Australia.
Yeah, but that's A U Australia.
Make an effort, Tony.
Australia.
Australia. Try and say Adelaide in Italian.
Adelaide.
Adelaide.
Bravissimo.
Bravo.
Grazie.
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 Si. Grazie, sì, because normally, like tourists, when they come to Italy, they always say grazie. Don't they,
yeah.
Leonora?
And they write it grazie without E at the very end.
Exactly.
And then so what do you do? Roll your eyes up and go, there's another Australian tourist.
Just another one. And so we say grazie. There's an E at the end.
Torta di mele con miele.
Sì, mele, apples.
Yeah.
Miele, honey.
So you just put the I in there and all of a sudden an apple becomes honey.
Exactly.
Easy.
Uova.
Mm.
So you wouldn't say an uova is a female.
That's an irregular word. Uovo is one and it's masculine. And then uovo, when it becomes plural, becomes feminine. It's a weird word.
Yeah, see, that's the weird part that I don't get about the Italian language. How this egg can become, on its own, it's male, and then have a sex change when it becomes two.
I know.
You know, I had that issue when I first started here 5.5 years ago, and I still don't know how it works.
There's not many words like that, though. They're just irregular.
That almost scares me. So, I thought, uova,
uova.
Is the plural.
Mm-hmm.
What's uva?
Grapes.
Oh, uva.
Uva.
Yeah.
Uva, facile.
Uva, si, si, si. Okay. Well, a word that a lot of Australians get wrong. You know, what did you have last night? Gnocchi.
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 Yeah, it's gnocchi.
Gnocchi. Yeah.
The G and the N.
Yeah, because the G and the N in English is like gn. Like bolognese. Bolognese. What do you say?
Bolognese.
Okay. And bolognese.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Bolognese.
Well, it comes from Bologna. That's
yeah,
why it's called bolognese.
They don't even eat it there, Sarah.
Why not?
Because they don't like it there. This is what I heard from Max, our art guy.
In Bologna, they don't like bolognese.
No.
I don't think so.
Well, maybe I'm wrong. Lasagna alla bolognese.
Double gne.
Yeah? Lasagna alla bolognese. Am I saying that right?
Sì, perfetto. Ti piacciono le lasagne?
I like any lasagna.
Sì. Anche al pesto?
Oh, I haven't had lasagna.
A Genova facciamo le lasagne al pesto.
No, my mum used to make cheese, salami, egg, cheese, salami, egg, sauce.
Very molto italiano.
Is there a problem with that?
It's not very Italian.
Well, it's not very Italian.
No.
No.
Well, how do you make it, Eleanor?
I already make it, but you just use for lasagna, bechamel and ragù.
Yeah, it's only bolognese or pesto.
Oh, so you don't put the egg in there? You don't put the salami?
No. Salami is not included.
That's very Australian.
Okay. What's beignet?
Un beignet è un pasticcino.
Molto buono.
A what? A pasticcino?
Un pasticcino. Un pasticcino, un piccolo dolce. It's a little cake.
Oh, what, yeah. What does it taste like?
Oh, normally inside
heaven.
What?
Heaven.
Heaven.
Heaven. Beignet.
Beignet. Like inside is like maybe chocolate or like custard, or it's just ridiculously good.
I don't understand how you Italian ladies are able to mandare la linea.
Mantenere
la linea when you eat this sort of stuff. So you look at you, you've got not one little ounce of extra weight on any of you bones anywhere.
I know.
And you eat all this beignet.
We dream of that. Personally, I tend not to eat that.
I can't remember last time I had a beignet, actually.
Okay, let's talk about the ly sounds.
Yeah.
Sì,
quindi
tagliatelle.
And I wanted to say this because every time I go to a restaurant in Melbourne, it always says tagliatelli o fettuccini.
Tagliatelle.
It is feminine. It's all finished with e. It's feminine, not masculine. Quindi fettuccine, tagliatelle.
Yeah. What's tagliere? Tagliere is tie up.
No, tagliare is to cut. E tagliere, yeah, it's where you cut stuff on.
Oh, the board. You
the
cut
board,
it on.
Sì.
Tagliere.
Tagliere.
Pasta, aglio e olio.
Bravo. If you're Italian, you can say this. Pasta, aglio e olio.
That's,
e peperoncino.
E peperoncino.
That's oil and aglio. That's aglio? Garlic.
Garlic, sì.
Okay. Yeah, I've had that. Tovaglia.
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 Sai cos'è la tovaglia, Tony?
No.
And tablecloth.
Oh, okay. Tovaglia.
Mm-hmm.
Tovagliolo.
Tovagliolo.
What's that?
It's a napkin.
Bottiglia, I know what a bottiglia is.
Sì, una that's bottiglia a... di vino. Yeah. O due bottiglie di vino.
O tre.
Un bottiglia di whisky.
Una bottiglia di whisky.
Cameriere?
Mm-hmm. Cameriere, so
that's
A.
A waiter.
Cameriere, sì.
Roccola.
Rucola.
Rucola.
Cos'è rucola?
Cos'è la rucola?
Buh. Rucola.
Rucola.
No idea.
Rocket.
Rocket.
Come l'insalata.
Ah, like a rocket going into space or a rocket salad?
Salad.
But can you use it as a rocket going?
No.
What's a rocket going to space?
Un razzo.
What?
Razzo.
Razzo. Mm. Well, carne, lo so che è carne. Ah, cucchiaino. Cucchiaino.
Cucchiaino is the best word. It's a little spoon.
Yeah, how do you say it?
Cucchiaino.
Cucchiaino. Yeah, that's got everything there, hasn't it?
Sì.
That's challenging.
Tutto.
That's a little spoon that you put sugar in to put in your coffee.
Sì.
Cucchiaino.
Giusto.
Bicchiere.
Mm-hmm.
Forchetta.
Mm-hmm.
A bruschetta. Now, a lot of Australians get this wrong. Because
that's why
I go to the restaurant and say, can I have some bruschetta, please? Bruschetta.
Bruschetta, sì.
Yes.
Incredibile.
Sometimes it's better just to say, yeah, okay, no worries, I'll bring it out.
You know when I pronounce Italian words in here, in Melbourne, they never understand me. Like the other day I was ordering a calzone and they just couldn't understand me. Because I guess here it's, how do you say calzone here? Like calzone?
Yeah, calzone. Calzone.
So I had to pronounce things in English.
Coscia. Di pollo.
Oh, una coscia di pollo. Cos'è una coscia?
Oh, no. Can I tell you something? Forget about the pollo part. But I love the sound of the word coscia. It's got a beautiful sound to it. So that is the leg of a chicken.
Sì. The thigh, actually.
It can be the thigh of anything, can't it?
Sì. Anche di una bella donna.
Sarah. Embarrassing me. Pesce.
Cos'è pesce?
It's a fish.
Fish.
Prosciutto.
Ah, oh, prosciutto.
The SC, when you PROSC, is a sh sound.
Sh, yeah, prosciutto.
Prosciutto.
Yeah, prosciutto. And the ham in Italian is prosciutto cotto. And what you call prosciutto, which is the Parma, it's prosciutto crudo.
Oh, okay.
Okay, people don't understand this difference, but in Italian, yeah, well, everything is prosciutto.
I didn't understand that either. All right, well, that's, yeah, some of these words I already knew, but other words I've picked up. I just have to remember, the problem now is remembering them.
Sì, infatti, now we have to practice them.
Torta di mele con miele.
Mm-hmm.
Coscia.
This is your favorite.
Due cosce di pollo.
Cosce. Due cosce di pollo.
You will never forget.
No, mai.
Sometimes I'm a bit juvenile, I can't help it. So,
why not? Why not?
Absolutely. Do you like the cosce di pollo?
No, actually.
Il pete, ti piace?
Sì, mi piace il petto.
Il petto è nice because it's white meat, isn't it?
Esatto, sì. Ma tutti mi dicono, oh, la coscia è più buona. No, mi piace il petto.
What about you, Eleanor?
Ala.
What?
Wings.
Ah, the wings. There's nothing on the wings.
Yeah, but it's funny.
Okay, Sarah is from a school called In Language Boutique, which is in Abbotsford.
Yes.
You've got a whole heap of students this year.
I know, like a full student. It's amazing.
Yeah.
But we're waiting for more because the second term is coming soon.
And they're learning Italian, they're learning Spanish, and they're learning French.
Yes.
What percentage are learning Italian?
I would say Italian is 60%.
60%. Yeah. Well, that's good.
Yeah.
Yeah. And are they Australians or, you know, people like me?
Yeah, half and half. Just yeah. Like Australians and like Australians with Italian background. Yeah.
Well, you make sure you be strict with them too, Sarah.
Yeah, I am.
Walk around with a big stick.
No.
And then hit them over the back of their head if they say bruschetta.
Yeah, no, my students didn't say bruschetta. No. They would not be allowed in the school doors. No, they're really nice.
What's your telephone number, Sarah, in case anybody wants to learn Italian?
0399 393939. So very easy.
Can you repeat that again?
Mm-hmm.
Too many three nines there.
Okay. 0399 393939.
Okay, and you'll get specialised help from Sarah, and within probably I don't know how long, a couple of months, you'll be okay. You'll learn a bit of Italian.
Yeah, for sure. Like the basis, you can go to Italy and order food.
And after 6 years, you'll be like me, still haven't learned anything.
No. It could be better.
Okay, Sara, grazie che sei venuto qui.
Grazie.
Stamattina aiutarmi a parlare italiano un po' più perfetto, perché io voglio tutto aiuto che è possibile.
Va bene, non ti preoccupare, ciao!
Mettiamo ciao. Una canzone e ritorniamo qui. In the studio we have Sara Chandler.
Buongiorno Tony.
Buongiorno Sara.
Buongiorno Eleonora.
Ciao.